Saiko and salam sejahtera. Now, let's discuss sketching a graph of quadratic function. Okay, so by using the flowchart method, let's discuss the question given. Okay, step 1, look at your equation, determine the shape of the graph. Okay, the shape of the graph. Okay, so this is the function hx equals to 3x squared minus 12, okay, 12x plus 10. Is it positive? Okay, if positive, then smile. What is the meaning of smile? That means, okay, the graph is, for example, like this, smile, right? Okay, put the eyes and nose, so you see the smile. Okay, and then, of course, yes, okay, positive, yes. And step 2, determine the position, okay, of the graph by using b squared minus 4ac. Okay, so if, just to revise back, if the value, okay, the value of discriminant, which is b squared minus 4ac, if greater than 0, meaning it's two distinct roots. Okay, if equals to 0, okay, equal root. Okay, equal roots. So that means one root. Okay, one value of x got two distinct root, right? Two value of x. And at less than zero, okay, no roots. Okay, no root. Okay, so this is what we are going to determine the position. Okay, so what is what do we do is substitute value of a, b, and c. So b squared. Okay, so b squared is negative 12 squared minus 4. A is equals to 3, and b equals to positive 10. So equals to 144 minus 120 equals to 24. Okay, so if you can see, okay, the value of discriminant is greater than 0, and what we get is greater than 0 is two distinct roots. Okay, so your conclusion is two different two different roots. Okay, this is what happened. Okay, and then step 3, find maximum or minimum point by using completing the square method. So this is fx equals to 3x squared minus 12x plus 10. Okay, so we by using the method too. Okay, so what do we do? 3 bracket x squared minus 4x plus 10 over 3, and then equals to 3, right? Value of b equals to negative b equals to negative 4 divided by 2, so you get negative 2. So x, we get x minus 2 squared minus negative 2 squared, and then plus 10 over 3 bracket close bracket, so 3. So we get x minus 2 bracket squared, okay, and minus 2 over 3, okay, and then expand, so you get 3x minus 2 bracket squared minus 2. Okay, this is the situation happened. Okay, so from the completing the squared, okay, we can get two values here. Okay, the situation happened is, okay, the graph, because of the graph is smile, so this is the value of, we call it as minimum. Okay, so for x and y. So from the general form of completing the square, we can get the value of point x coordinate and y coordinate. Okay, so the negative 2 actually is the value of the minimum value, okay, which is y coordinate of the turning point. Okay, equals to negative 2. Okay, point x or coordinate x, okay, right, so we equate 3 bracket minus 2 squared must be equal to 0. Okay, from here you can see, so x minus 2, right, equals to 0, therefore x equals to 2. All right, from here we can answer the step 4. Yeah, and then, so what is the minimum? Okay, this is minimum point. Okay, x equals to 2, and coordinate y equals to negative 2. Okay, and then step 5, find the x-intercept when fx equals to 0. Okay, from here this is not fx but hx equals to 0. Okay, meaning we solve. Okay, solve the completing the square. So 3x minus 2 squared minus 2 equals to 0. Okay, so after you simplify, I make it short. Okay, so so we get like this. Okay, this example, right, this is the answer for x. Okay, right, from the previous example, alright, so we get x minus 2 equals to plus minus 2 over 3. Therefore, answer for x1 equals to 6 plus 6 over 3 over 2 sorry over 3 alright over 3 meanwhile x2 equals to 6 minus 6 over 3. So this answer I'll get it from the previous example. Okay, and then step 6, right? Step 6, find the y-intercept when x equals to 0. Okay, so y-intercept, we cannot use completing the square method. Okay, we use the function itself. So 3x squared minus 12x plus 10. So because of x equals to 0, okay, so 0, that means this one also 0, this one equals to 0. Therefore, y-intercept or x equals to fx equals to 10. Okay, so this is how. Now last step, step 7, okay, sketch the graph, right, from the information given. Okay, so we know, okay, this is what happened, this is what exists, and x exists. Okay, the position, okay, the position of graph is two distinct root, and the shape of graph is smile. So smile, two distinct root. Okay, this is the value of 6 plus 6 over 3, and this is 6 minus 6 over 3. This one is 0, and then the minimum point, okay, the lowest point is 2 negative 2. Okay, so this is 2. Okay, and then the y-intercept is 10. Okay, this is how you sketch the quadratic graph. You must, the point here is you must know what is the y-intercept, of course, minimum point, okay, from the completing the square, as well as the value of, if two distinct root, that means the value of x-intercept, okay, x-intercept, alright. Okay, so the second graph, okay, we are going to sketch graph of with modulus. Okay, with modulus. So how we sketch the modulus? Okay, so from here, right, we know the value of let y equals to x minus 7, x plus 7 equals to 0. That means the value of x-intercept, okay, so x minus 7 equals to 0, x equals to 7, and x plus 7 equals to 0, so x equal to negative 7. Okay, so for this graph, what we must sketch is the original graph, the quadratic graph without the modulus first. Okay, and then we reflect. Okay, you see, and then what do we do? This is when y equals to 0. Okay, the first one, the second one. So when x equals to 0, okay, so we get x equals to 0 minus 7 times 0 plus 7. So negative 7 times 7 equals to negative 49. Okay, so we have the value here, value of x-intercept and y-intercept, negative 49. So okay, this is y-axis, and this is x-axis. Okay, the graph is positive, so smile, right? So smile, and the x-intercept negative 7 and 7. And then, okay, the because of the distance between 0 to negative 7 and 7 are same, so this is actually the minimum point, negative 49. Okay, this is graph for y equals to x minus 7 bracket x plus 7. Okay, because of there is modulus, that means we have to reflect. Okay, reflect like this. Okay, okay, so this is negative 49, so if you reflect, it become 49. Okay, so this is the graph for modulus. Okay, so what happened to this one? Okay, so what do? We delete, right? Delete, okay, delete, and then make sure, okay, there is no like this. Okay, so this is the type of modulus graph, quadratic graph, when there is a modulus. Okay, all positive for value are positive for modulus. Okay, this is how you sketch the graph, okay, without modulus and with modulus, and this is the steps by using the flowchart. Okay, so I hope you can see it is easy to sketch the quadratic graph, okay, as long as you know the step. Okay, until now, thank you.